អង្គុយចុះអង្គជំរាបការបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការនៅទីប្រឹក្សាអំណាចការនឹងផ្ដល់វិការជូនទៅសាប្រញ្ញារងអន្តរជាតិដើម្បីបន្តការតាំងសម្ពុទ្ធនេះដល់ចំពោះសាក់សី
Thank you, Mr. President. I was asking you, I handed you the WRI of a person that you identified as the commander of intervention of Brigade of Division 221. Indeed, in his own interview, he acknowledges that he was the commander of Intervention Brigade 221.
I have a general question
for you. What is the function of an intervention division or brigade? You identified 221 as having that function. Also, when you talked about your previous division, Division 1 in the West Zone, this is in your interview, E3-4593-12. You described Division 1 as consisting of regiments 15, 16, 17, an artillery regiment, and an intervention unit. But it specifically in relation to the unit in Svai Ring, what was the function of, what is the function of an intervention brigade?
ខ្ញុំសូមបញ្ជាក់ពួកកងនៃអន្តរាគមន៍នេះមិនមុខងារធ្វើអ្វីដែរខ្ញុំសូមបញ្ជាក់ពួកកងនៃអន្តរាគមន៍នេះមិនមែនជារបស់ស្មើជើងគឺរបស់ខាងនៃវិរៈសន្តិការខាងកងពលធំខាងតរៃនឹងគេគ្រប់គ្រងនេះវាភារកិច្ចគេចាត់ចែងជួយឲ្យលោកមានជួយទៅបន្ថែមបន្ថយកន្លែងណានឹងខ្ញុំមិនដឹងដែរគឺគាត់ភារកិច្ចរបស់ពួកគេខាងអន្តរាគមន៍
My question is more general. How is a intervention brigade different from or regiment? How is it different from the other regular regiments? What is it? How are its functions different than the other units?
Kong antara kumpi pihak kai bakluan timur ku nampai thom na tai bermin muk senyap sen dan min lengta lengter yap.
Would it be accurate to say that an intervention brigade is one that would be considered mobile and that it would be deployed around at different locations depending on the situation? Now you've indicated that the battlefront at the time you arrived in Svai Ring was at the border in the Bavet area. Did that change at all between June 1978 and at least the start of December 1978? Was there any movement back and forth or movement in the battle front where you were fighting in the first 5 months that you were in Svai Ring?
ក្នុងពេលសភាពដែលខ្ញុំចូលជើងនៅរយៈប៉ុណ្ណឹងខែខ្ញុំនួនពេលវេលានោះគឺមានសភាពការតឹងតែងជាការនៃជការយួននោះវានាំបុករយល់កោះមកបុកយើងប្រងកំភ្លើងធំដាក់យើងអានឹងគឺបាញ់គ្នាតតុលតមកនឹងខាងដែរនឹងគឺសភាពការគឺតឹងតែងនៅកន្លែងនៅពេលនោះ
My question was, at least prior to the time in December 78, at the end of the year where Vietnamese forces broke through, did they push your troops back from the border Or did the fighting remain in the same general area of Tibet?
រុញថយមកទីតាំងសមរភូមិនៅបវត្តឬក៏យ៉ាងណាមុនយួនចូលមកបុកធ្លាមកស្នេហ៍ចូលពេញស្រុកខ្មែរនោះគឺពួកនោះគឺព្រំដែនគឺវាយពួកយើងខ្ញុំមកថយមកធ្លាមកចិត្តមកដល់ផ្លូវលេខ 1 ឬក៏ខ្លះនៅលើផ្លូវលេខ 1ខ្លះនៅក្រមផ្លូវលេខ 1
My colleague from the defense asked you a question yesterday about the civilian population. You said you didn't see any civilians in Svayrang or Nevet towns. She also read to you part of a report that came from Sector 23, Sectors 23 and 24, twin sectors at the time, from May 1978. And I wanted to just read to you what the May 78 report from the region sent to said about the civilian population. This report regarding we have withdrawn people from four districts who live inside our territory. Those districts are Basak District, Chantria District, Samrong District,
Samrong,
and then continuing on a later section on people's livelihood. English. English 0815 1 3 4 6 0 8 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4 6 0 8 5 2 1 3 4
ដោយសារតែស្រូវអង្ករទាំងអស់ហ្នឹងគឺថាត្រូវបានបំផ្លិចបំផ្លាញនិងលួចយក
ដែលខ្ញុំទៅដល់ស្វាយរៀងនឹងគឺអត់មានឃើញប្រជាជននៅកន្លែងណាអីអត់មានប្រជាជនម្នាក់ក៏អត់មានផង ដូច្នេះ ហើយខ្ញុំក៏អត់ស្គាល់ថាយ៉ាងម៉េចដែរគឺទៅដល់គឺដឹងតែគេដាក់នៅមុំគឺរឿងទៅឯខាងក្រោយគឺយើងខ្ញុំអត់មានទទួលដឹងអត់មានទទួលស្គាល់ឬថាជាជនគេនៅកន្លែងណាហើយជីវភាពរស់នៅការហូបចុកខ្វះខាតអីអានឹងគឺខ្ញុំដឹងតែការគ្រប់គ្រងខាងយោធានឹងគឺដឹកនាំប្រយុទ្ធការ
And you were asked some questions already about San Sen. I may come back to ask you a little more about this later. As I'm finishing some questions about the structure of arrangements there, I wanted to read to you the OCIJ statement of a witness this is what he testified.
Quote,
later on in 1977, the Central Committee assigned San Sen to station at the front line when the Vietnamese attacked in Spy Ring. Later on, San Sen took me to work at the communication radio and logistics in Spy Ring office in late 1977. The thing I wanted to specifically ask you about is this witness refers to a communication radio and logistics office in Spy Ring. Did you know this office? And do you remember where it was located and who worked there? Did you know a communications radio and logistics office in Spy Ring that was used during the time your troops were deployed there? I want to ask you now, turn now to get some details about the fighting that took place. Can you describe for us, the combat that took place between your troops and the Vietnamese forces? What was the nature of the fighting? Well, during the 6 months that you were out, approximately 6 months you were in Spy Ring, how often was there fighting between your troops and the Vietnamese? Was this something that took place every day, or was it more sporadic?
Were there many casualties in your
brigade or division in 340? Can you tell us how many casualties your brigade suffered during these 6 months of fighting?
ក្នុងពេលប្រយុទ្ធគ្នាប្រមួយខែហ្នឹងគឺមានការលបួសនឹងស្លាប់បន្តិចតួចទេព្រោះយើងមានតង់សេមានកន្លែងយើងត្រៀមការពារអស់ហើយដូច្នេះយើងមិនទៅប្រយុទ្ធទាំងកំរោលណាគឺទៅវាថាមានកន្លែងតង់សេយើងទៅអីឲ្យអស់ហើយដូច្នេះអត់ទៅមានគ្រោះថ្នាក់ម៉ានទេ
So are you saying that when the fighting ended, when the Vietnamese broke through, that most of the people, most of the soldiers in, that were under your command were still alive? Is that correct? I understand that, but prior to the time you fled, are you saying that of the 1,000 troops that were under your command, who you had brought from you to the West Zone, there had only been a few casualties?
ឡានដឹកអីចេញមកគ្រួយអស់មានអីនោះមកសមរភូមិគ្រួយមកទីពេទ្យគេគ្រួយអស់ហើយកម្លាំងដែលនៅសល់ហ្នឹងក៏យើងដឹងថាបែកខ្ចែកខ្ញាយគ្នាអស់ហើយរត់ព្រោះកាលនោះយន្តហោះក៏មានមកជើងកមោដូចនេះបែកខ្ញាយគ្នាមិនដឹងទៅខាងណាខាងណីក៏ស្ដាប់អត់បាន
Was there also aerial attacks or bombing conducted by Vietnamese planes in your area? And if so, when did that begin?
ហើយបើសិនណាជាមានការបាញ់ប្លោងពីសំណាក់យន្តហោះនេះតើលោកដឹងថាបាញ់នៅដំណាដែរ
ខ្ញុំសូមបញ្ជាក់គឺកំភ្លើងធំក៏ប្លោងហើយឡានហោះបាញ់ហោះពីលើនឹងគឺបាញ់តាមម្ដុំផ្លូវលេខ1ហ្នឹងមកកើតមកពីលេខកងទ័ពរត់ចាប់ខ្ចាយហ្នឹងគឺមានឡានហោះទម្លាក់ក៏កំភ្លើងធំបាញ់ប្លោងនឹងគឺមកតាហ្នឹងគឺកងទ័ពរត់បែកខ្ញែកគ្នាពេលហ្នឹងគឺសូមបញ្ជាក់
And when was it that you were dispersed to a different location? How long after your initial arrival?
No,
so you're just saying
you move to avoid the aerial attacks. ឡានហោះក៏ទម្លាក់ក្របផ្លោងក៏ផ្លោងដូច្នេះកងទ័ពនៅមិនបានក៏នោះនេះរត់មកថយជួយមកបែកខ្ញែកគ្នាអស់ដំណឹងការប្រយុទ្ធគឺបញ្ចប់ដំណឹងហើយធ្វើអស់កងទ័ពនឹងមកដល់មានក្តាប់កូនអត់បានកូនក្តាប់មានអត់បានដឹងរត់ទៅណាម្នាក់ម្នាក់យកតែយុរៀងខ្លួន
So just to be clear, you're saying that the shelling and the aerial attacks became intense towards the end of the 78 at the time that you had to retreat. Is that correct?
Man.
Do you remember what types of planes the Vietnamese were using for these aerial attacks? And did your division have any weapons or any anti-aircraft weapons or any way of defending against attacks by these airplanes?
សម្រាប់អង្គភាពខ្ញុំគឺអត់មានកំភ្លើងអីបាញ់ការពារយន្តហោះទេតែឃើញថាកងទ័ពរបស់ខាងលើអានឹងគឺខ្ញុំក្រាប់ម៉ានព្រោះថាសម្រាប់អង្គភាពខ្ញុំមានតែសម្រាប់បាញ់ថ្មើរជើងនោះទេអត់មានសម្រាប់បាញ់យន្តហោះទេ
Now, another subject that you talked about a little yesterday was the use of mines. Do I understand correctly that mines were laid to defend against the Vietnamese? And if so, where was it that these mines were planted?
តើគ្រាប់មីនទាំងអស់ហ្នឹងណាគេបង្កប់វានៅកន្លែងណាដែរនេះពេលដែលយួនបុកធ្លីហើយដូចនេះពេលហ្នឹងគឺគ្មានបានប្រកប់មីនប្រកប់អីគឺរត់ចោលអីវ៉ាន់ទាំងអស់គាត់មាននេះទេអត់មានបានដាក់មីនអីទេកំភ្លើងយកមកនឹងតាន់ផងពូវាមកច្រើនហើយមិនលើទុកប៉ុន្មានអត់មានបានដាក់មីនអីទេ
I'm not talking now about the end of 78 when the Vietnamese broke through. I'm talking about when you first arrived in June 78. Were mines in use at the border at the time?
ពេលខ្ញុំទៅដល់ទីដំបូងអត់មានដាក់មីនតាមព្រំដែនទេពូកងទ័ពចុះឡើងខ្លាចច្រឡំដែរអត់មានដាក់ទេ
What about punji pits or spike traps? Were any of those, did you have any of those protecting the border in the
Babette area?
ចំពោះជំរងនៅទីតាំងបវត្តអត់មានដាក់ទេដាក់នៅតាមព្រំដែនជំរងបិទអសីនឹងធ្វើដោតទៅប៉ុន្តែនេះនឹងមានដោតជំរងនេះនឹងឯក្រុមបវត្តអត់មានដាក់ទេព្រោះនឹងខាងក្រោយនោះគឺចល័តតបចល័តដើរចុះឡើងមិនហ៊ានដាក់ផ្លាច់មុតដែរ
In relation to the spike traps, I want to read to you another excerpt that came from that May 1978 report from Sector 23. Again, this is E3-862, Khmer 00021020, English 00185, 208 and French 00814598. This is in section 1 of the report on the external enemies in sector 23. And it says the following, quote, "We have raised people's motivation to make
1,635,380 spike trap.
This, based on this contemporaneous report, there seems to be quite an effort underway inspiring to build these spike traps. Can you describe what these spike traps were like? And specifically, where were they put at the border? How far at the border?
ហើយអមចម្រងនឹងគេដាក់បង្កាយវាបង្កប់វាដល់របៀបណាដែរចម្រងសូមបញ្ជាក់ពីចម្រងគេធ្វើពីរស្សីបង្វែងហើយជាបីទឹកអីនោះទេនេះបិទស្រួចបិទឲ្យស្រួចហើយយើងទុញទងនឹងដាក់ដោតតាមកន្លែងណាដែលយើងផុតខ្សែទាមយើងឲ្យគាត់ដាក់នេះប៉ុណ្ណឹងអញ្ចឹង
Ask you about a document that came from the standing committee of the very top leaders in Phnom Penh. This appears in minutes of a August 1975 trip they took to the northwest zone.
It's document E3/216.
Section 2.1.B.2 of the minutes
Were
there many Vietnamese soldiers who were wounded by the spike traps? I want to ask you a few questions about attacks into Vietnam. did your Vietnam, division or any of the divisions that were under Ren's command engage in any combat or fighting that took place inside Vietnam?
Vietnam.
I want to ask you, Dan, about some evidence that seems to show
Et pour compléter l'objection de mon confrère à laquelle je m'associe évidemment, je note que de la réponse précédente et des réponses antérieures du témoin indiquaient que lui il était en charge de sa seule unité et que son unité n'est certainement pas allée en territoire vietnamien. Il n'y a pas de raison de lui opposer autre chose. Il parle de ce qu'il sait. Donc, lui opposer des éléments qui, de surcroît, sont en dehors du champ du procès n'est pas acceptable. Donc, nous objectons d'autant plus fort.
If I may respond, it's simply false to say it's outside the scope. Incursions into Vietnam is a crime, or not included, but it is obviously specifically part of the conflict that is part of the allegations related to the existence of an armed conflict. And indeed, if you look at the closing order, if you look at the paragraphs related to the armed conflict that are incorporated as part of this case, paragraph 153 of the closing order,
ហើយចំណែកឯសំណួរមួយទៀតហ្នឹងដែលមួយទៀតគឺថាអាសាក់សេមតន់ឆ្លើយទេរឿងដឹងមិនដឹងព្រោះអាកាដឹងមិនមែនចាំបាច់ទៅដល់បានដឹងទេអាកាដឹងវាព័ត៌មានផ្សេងៗបើពួកយើងសួរកន្លងមកសន្តិលើគេថាក៏សួរដែររួមទាំងមេធាវីការពារក្តីទាំងសងខាងផងជឿជឿបន្តសំណួរ
Thank you, Mr. President.
So I'd like to
start with
a statement from a witness who was one of the soldiers sent out to
fight the Vietnamese in the east,
Khong
Kim. This is from DC Cam
interview
English 0-0-0-4-3-8-9-7-3-7-4. This is what this individual said. A question. When you entered, attacked and entered Thai Ninh, what happened to the people there? Let me stop first, Mr. Witness. Was Thai Ninh, in fact, the Vietnamese province that was directly on the other side of the border from Vietnam
event,
was that Thai
Ninh
province?
Well,
this witness, the soldier, described entering and describes the details of the attacking. Question. What was the name of your division commander when you went to fight the Vietnamese? Answer. Pon. Where was Pon from?
Pon.
Answer. He was from Takao. The end of quote. My question to you, Mr. Witness. You've identified in your OCIJ statements the brigades that were under the command of Bren. Was one of those four divisions, division 460, which was commanded by a person named Pon from the southwest zone?
And
the division he commanded, 460, that was part of the consolidated
divisions
another a witness this is Lay In OCIJ statement E3-376, Khmer 00-270-173-78-690-691. A French 0-0-486-0-9-4. He says in this interview, quote, about 7 months before 7 January 1979, I was ordered to organize former combatants into groups for fighting the Vietnamese. All chiefs of the group, the regiment, and the division were all southwest zone cadres. We went to fight Well, I now want to ask you about a specific incident that was reported by the Vietnamese News Agency, VNA, in October 1988, in which it was reported that both your division, the 340, and the Special Intervention Brigade 221 had engaged in an attack across the Vietnamese border into Ben Cao. This is what that it's a VNA report dated 12 October 1978.
Quote,
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Une nouvelle objection dans la formulation de la question de Monsieur le Co-procureur. Il a indiqué qu'il s'agit de votre division 340, compte tenu des réponses précédentes du témoin qui a expliqué que dans le cadre de l'organisation des combats, il n'avait absolument aucun contact avec les autres brigades pendant cette division. Aujourd'hui, parler de façon générale d'une attaque qui indique ne pas avoir mené à laquelle il n'a pas participé compte tenu de sa déposition, le prémisse est faux. Et la question n'est pas justifiée, puisque le témoin ne va pas pouvoir éclairer la Chambre sur ce point. Ça a été déjà dit dans ses déclarations précédentes. Donc, j'objecte à la question.
Mr. President, in addition, Case 002/02 is We are acting, we are defending our client on the assumption that we will not be dealing with incursions in Vietnamese territory. So we have to prepare. We do not know whether they are reliable.
ដែលថាហេតុអ្វីក៏លើកយករបាយការណ៍បែបនេះឬក៏កំណត់ត្រាបែបនេះព្រោះថាមេធាវីការពីក្តីត្រូវដឹងថាតើការសវនកម្មនឹងធ្វើពីអ្វីវាមិនអាចថាយើងគ្រាន់តែនិយាយថាយើងនិយាយស្អីក៏បានតាមចិត្តនោះទេព្រោះថាមេធាវីការពីក្តីគេត្រូវតែមាន ស្ថានភាពមួយដែលអាចត្រៀមការពារខ្លួនបានយ៉ាងល្អហើយដូច្នេះខ្ញុំគិតថាដល់ពេលដែលលើកយកផ្ដាងអង្គហេតុគឺចាំបាច់ណាស់ដែលត្រូវឲ្យយើងច្បាស់ថាយើងនឹងមិនពិភាក្សាអំពីការឈ្លានពានចូលទៅក្នុងទឹកដីវៀតណាមនោះទេដូច្នេះខ្ញុំសូមដល់អង្គជំនុំជម្រះមេត្តាហាមឃាត់ចំពោះសំណួរបែបនេះ
ព្រះញ្ញាលោកភៀនខ្ញុំគិតថាវាជារឿងគួរឲ្យកត់សម្គាល់មួយដែលថាលោកមេធាវីកូពេនឡើងដងហើយម្តងទៀតម្តងហើយម្តងទៀតដែលថាគាត់និយាយថាវៀតណាមគឺជាអ្នកចាប់ផ្ដើមបង្កករឿងប៉ុន្តែឥឡូវហ្នឹងបែរជាគាត់និយាយទៅវិញថាគាត់មិនបានត្រៀមអំពីបញ្ហានេះខ្ញុំសូមបញ្ជាក់ថាប្រកាសថាវាគឺជាការនិយាយអំពីចំនួន
ប្រដាប់អាវុធដែលតាក់ទងទៅនឹងសាក់សីរូបនេះហើយកងពលរបស់គាត់គឺមានបញ្ជាក់ច្បាស់នៅក្នុងរបាយការណ៍នេះតែម្ដងគឺជារបាយការណ៍ដែលខ្ញុំគ្រងនឹងលើកយកមកអាននេះបាទអញ្ចឹងរះសម្រាប់បដិសេធនៅស្ដីជំទាស់របស់មេធាវីទាំងពីរក្រុមចំពោះសំណួរនេះហើយមានភាពពាក់ព័ន្ធអំពីចំនួនប្រដាប់អាវុធវាមានតំណែងតំណងគ្នាយើងបានបញ្ជាក់ហើយថាពិតមែនតែវាមិនសួរដេញដោលស៊ីជំរឿ ទៅលើអង្គហេតុលំអិតឬអង្គហេតុនៅក្រៅវិសាលភាពប៉ុន្តែពាក្យចំនួនរបស់អាវុធពាក្យឈ្លោះនេះបានន័យថាវាមានទៅវាមានមកអញ្ចឹងហើយបានយើងវាចង់ដឹងថាតើវាមានភាពពាក់ព័ន្ធនេះយ៉ាងដូចមិនដេចខ្លះអំពីតំណែងតំណងនៃចំនួនប្រដាប់អាវុធនេះបានវាកើតឡើងជាចំនួនឡើងហើយសាក់សីអាចឆ្លើយបានព្រោះមេធាវីយើងបានប្រាប់អញ្ចឹងយើងបានចម្លឹកហើយថាសួរ រហូតដល់គាត់ដឹងលឺពីណាមកក៏គាត់សួរដែរមិនមែនសួរសាក់សីបានឃើញផ្ទាល់ដឹងផ្ទាល់បានសួរបានទេហើយមិញគាត់បានឆ្លើយហើយអំពីកងពលផ្សេងៗទៀតគាត់បានដឹងអញ្ចឹងពាក្យថាដឹងនេះគឺមានន័យទៅទូលំទូលាយជាងអ្វីដែលបានឃើញផ្ទាល់នឹងភ្នែកបានសួរដេញដោលប្រសាសូមជួយបន្តលោកថាបញ្ញារងអន្តរជាតិ
Thank you, Mr. President.
So
this is a report from Mr. Witness relating to October 1978, and it states as follows, quote, On 1 October, Pol Pot Ing Sari troops of the 221 launched a large-scale attack in an attempt to occupy the enclaves along the Vietnamese defense perimeter in western Ben Khao, Thailand province. One Kampuchean regiment sustained heavy losses. More than 100 troops were killed on the spot. A number of others were captured together with a large quantity of weapons. On the same day, the Vietnamese armed forces wiped out a Kampuchean battalion of the 340th Division. That is Division 340, a 3-kilometer squad from western Ben Khao. This refresh your memory at all. Do you remember an incident in which some troops from your division 340 and some troops from the division 221, the intervention brigade, attacked the Vietnamese defense in western Ben Khao, inside Vietnam?
ខ្ញុំសូមបញ្ជាក់ហើយក៏សូមបញ្ជាក់ថែមទៀតថាចំពោះខ្ញុំគឺអង្គភាពខ្ញុំដែលគេថាទៅចូលទៅវៀតណាមណាគឺខ្ញុំអត់ទេគឺខ្ញុំវាយនៅនេះនឹងខាងលិចនឹងអត់មានបានចូលទឹកដីយួនអីណាទេតែវាយនៅតែនេះគឺខ្ញុំទប់នៅម្ដុំប្រសូត nom ai nung te khư khom ot mien ban riep cham kamlang tau te ot nung ai kong po phsei te khom bichea chang tha kran te lue chmuh pontae man dai skol hai ko man dai khoeng po khang lue chmuh phea tha lo mo yut nung mien kong pol nih mo thaem nung lai nung dai dai kran ke tha te yeung man dai chuop mok phong hai ko man dai skol ke tiet nung khom som bichea chang men tha kran te lue chmuh hai tha nung ko chbas luas chieng khoe chea dai ke ot te khom te nung ko khom ot ton khom chlai ot ka dai
Well, Mr. Witness, you stated in a number of occasions in your interview when you confirmed with counsel yesterday that the division commanded by Thi Phu Se that you were deputy of was 340. Let me ask you this, were any of the soldiers in your division 340 ever captured by Vietnamese troops?
ពេលនោះខ្ញុំក្តាប់អត់បានដែរពួកការប្រយុទ្ធវាមិនដឹងគេចាប់បានយើងចាប់បានគេនោះគឺខ្ញុំក្តាប់អត់បាន
Let me ask you this. This report from the Vietnamese news agency correctly identifies both the number of your division 340 and the number of the special intervention brigade 221. Were the numbers of, was the number of your brigade public knowledge, or is this something that would have happened? Would have only been fired if Vietnamese had captured soldiers from your division. Can you tell us, was it publicly known that the numbers of your division, or was that information only within the
Khmer
Cadre?
J'objecte à nouveau à la manière
dont
la question est posée par le procureur. Il parle de la division 340 alors que très clairement, de façon générale, de façon globale, alors que très clairement, le témoin indiqué dans ses déclarations précédentes et notamment à nous, en répondant à mes questions sur la manière dont sont organisées les choses sur le champ de bataille, il a bien expliqué que sa brigade à lui était à un endroit très particulier et qu'il ne savait pas ce qui s'est passé avec les autres brigades, dont la brigade d'intervention. Aujourd'hui, M. le procureur veut lui opposer comme s'il y avait une contradiction avec ses propos des éléments relatifs à une brigade d'intervention qu'il ne connaissait pas, qui ne dirigeait pas et avec laquelle il a indiqué qu'il n'avait pas de contact. Donc présenter cela comme une contradiction est quelque chose de faux et ce n'est pas juste à l'égard du témoin. Encore une fois, il a déjà déposé, il a déjà donné des explications sur comment s'organiser son travail au niveau de sa brigade et quelle était sa manière de défendre la partie du territoire qui lui était allouée. Lui opposer des éléments relatifs à d'autres brigades qu'il ne maîtrisait pas, ce n'est pas juste à son égard, et présenter cela comme une contradiction est une manière qui ne correspond pas à ce que l'on doit faire dans le cadre d'un interrogatoire, et j'objecte à cette question.
Yes, Mr. President, and on top of this,
this is Vietnamese propaganda.
And why it should be anything other than Vietnamese propaganda across the citizens. Why should we begin to believe whatever the Vietnamese
officials are saying? That's certainly not the time to evaluate the evidence, to testify on the evidence.
But the prosecution is constructing a contradiction between the witness testimony and this. We don't know what it is.
And you still have time to come.
Let me rephrase so my question is clearly about your division 340.
ច្បាស់អំពីកងពលបីរយសែសិបរបស់លោកថាតើរបាយការណ៍នឹងបានបញ្ជាក់ច្បាស់ដែរទេអំពីកងពលបីរយសែសិបថាតើលេខកងពលរបស់លោកនឹងត្រូវបានគេផ្សព្វផ្សាយឬក៏គេប្រកាសជាសាធារណៈឬមួយក៏វាជាលេខសម្ងាត់ដែលដឹងតែក្នុងកងទ័ពរបស់កម្ពុជាប្រជាធិបតេយ្យនោះទេ
ខ្ញុំសូមបញ្ជាក់លេខកងពល 3 ខ្សែនេះគឺទើបតែទៅដាក់ឈ្មោះនឹងនៅឆ្នាំ 78នឹងដែលទៅវាយនៅយួននឹងទេទើបបង្កើតនឹងទេដូច្នេះថាមិនបានដូចជាផ្សាយដឹងមិនដឹងជាទូទៅអានឹងគឺមិនដឹងគ្រាន់តែមករៀបចំកងពល 3 ខ្សែនឹងដែលមានខ្ញុំមកទីពុះសេនឹងដឹកនាំគឺគឺគាត់នៅប្រកាសតែប៉ុណ្ណឹងដែរ
And my question was, did you publicize the number of your battalion, or was that confidential information only known within the military?
លេខនេះគឺដឹងតែក្នុងកងទ័ពទេព្រោះប្រយុទ្ធនៅឆ្នាំ78នៅប្រយុទ្ធជិតចាញ់យួនហ្នឹងហើយគឺរៀបចំកម្លាំងឈ្មោះលេខកងឈ្មោះកងហ្នឹងលេខហ្នឹងគឺ
78ដែលជិតយួនបុកធ្លាហ្នឹងទេគឺអត់មានបានប្រកាសទៅខាងណាខាងណីទៀតហ្នឹងគឺខ្ញុំក៏បានគាត់គឺបានដឹងតែប៉ុណ្ណឹងក្នុងចំណោមអង្គភាពដែលរស់នៅជុំវិញហ្នឹងប៉ុណ្ណឹង Let me turn to another subject, which is whether your division
captured the Vietnamese soldiers during the 6 months that you were in Vietnam.
ជាមួយយួនមួយខែនេះគឺអត់មានបានចាប់យួនអីមួយទេម្នាក់ក៏អត់តែគាត់បានមកបាញ់គ្នាទៅវិញទៅមកហ្នឹងគឺប៉ុណ្ណឹងតែឲ្យចាប់រស់បានគឺអត់មាន
How is it possible that six months of combat, how did you manage to capture six enemy men?
Well, let me confront you with some evidence on this question, Mr. Witness. Let me start with a publication by the Democratic Kampuchea government titled The Account of Vietnam's Aggression Against the Democratic Kampuchea. Which stated as follows. Recently, on 24 July 1978, Vietnam desperately desperate to attack Kampuchea. Took on the enemy ferociously and specifically annihilated an entire battalion of the Vietnamese aggression. The 5th Battalion of the 7th Brigade
Việt Nam cứ có
all of the men and officers of the 7th company of this battalion were killed. There was only one survivor, Sergeant Major Nguyen Van Kay survived, who was captured by our army that day.
And
subsequently, the DK radio broadcasted the confession of that Vietnamese captured in Babet.
You'll
find this, Your Honor, E3/75, English 00168. Translation is available presently. And Mr. Witness, I'll also tell you that
on the
12th of September 1978, the DK radio from Phnom Penh broadcast another confession of a Vietnamese POW captured on the 9th of August, also at Babet. This is E3/13/22. Does that refresh your memory at all? Mr. Witness,
I was not correct that there were some Vietnamese soldiers in Vietnam in July and August 1978. យើងកាក៏ខ្ញុំក្រោកអត់បានដែរអត់ត្រូវបានស្ដាប់ដែរពួកគ្មានបច្ចុប្បន្នអីណាស់បានស្ដាប់ទេហើយបើនិយាយពីការវាយលុកចូលទៅជ្រៅក្នុងទឹកដីយួនអីអានេះក៏ខ្ញុំនឹងអង្គភាពខ្ញុំហើយខ្ញុំក៏គ្មានមានលទ្ធភាពនឹងទៅធ្វើការដែរដូចនេះខ្ញុំធ្វើធ្វើមកទួលនីតិខ្ញុំដែរខ្ញុំវាយទប់នៅព្រំដែនទេដូចនេះសំណួរដែលសួរទាំងអស់គឺខ្ញុំឆ្លើយអត់កើតហើយខ្ញុំឆ្លើយអត់បានពួកខ្ញុំអត់បានទឹកដឹកនាំធ្វើក៏
Mr. President, I can break here or continue.
Hien ta ta khnyom ko banto te tiet ko chup samra san.
Jeung prathean ong jomreah jeung nang lay pe lu bo dambei chuchul ka bat bong pe velia phieki peapon tuk latthaphiep jeung neak samrob samruol leu panha pe velia.
Thank you.
Sum akun lok prathean.
You were still in charge of the troops at the Babette spearhead in July and August 1978, is that correct?
ខ្ញុំក្តាប់អត់ទៅបានថ្ងៃខែទេនៅបវត្តគឺបើតាមខ្ញុំដែលទៅនៅនោះហើយទៅដល់នោះដែលឃើញវាយយួនហើយចាប់បានយួនអត់ដែលឃើញអត់មានប្រយុទ្ធនេះធំនៅបវត្តនោះផងអត់ដែលមានទេខ្ញុំហើយអង្គភាពខ្ញុំទៅដល់ហើយខ្លួនអត់ដែលឃើញបានប្រយុទ្ធអីហើយចាប់យួនបានអត់មាន
Well, let me ask you this. Did you have any instructions from your superiors on what you were to do if you did capture enemy soldiers? Did you have instructions of what to do, where to send any soldiers who were captured?
ក្នុងនៃសិលធម៌របស់នៃកម្ពុជាតបតែមានសិលថាជ្រួយសឹកដែលចាប់បានមកគឺអត់ឲ្យជីឲ្យវាដំអីទេគឺអត់ឲ្យមានធ្វើបាបធ្វើអីទេគឺជ្រួយសឹកគឺច្បាប់មានតែខ្ញុំអត់ដែលមានចាប់បានជ្រួយសឹកអីមួយទេ
And what was your instructions in terms of where you were to sendVietnamese soldiers who were captured.
តើគេមានបញ្ជាថាទាហានវៀតណាមទៅចាប់បាននឹងឬក៏ទាហានទៅចាប់ខ្លួនបាននឹងត្រូវបញ្ជូនទៅណាឬក៏យកទៅណាដែរ
អត់មានបញ្ជាអីផងបើទាហានថាបើយើងចាប់បាននៅក្នុងសមរភូមិបាននឹងបញ្ជូនមកមីងក្រួយផងមីងបញ្ជូនមកក្រួយទៅថានៅសមរភូមិក្រួយនឹងគេយកទៅខាងណានឹងគឺក្តៅអត់បានដែរបើសិនជាចាប់បានទេតែខ្ញុំមិនអង្គភាពខ្ញុំមិនដែលចាប់បានទេ
On the subject, Mr. Witness, let me read to you from the interview of one of the regiment commanders from 703. This was one of the part of the consolidated division commanded by Wren in his OCIJ statement E3/361. Khmer 001 4 6 9 English 0 7 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4 5 4
Near Svai Ring, Phnom Penh, were sent to Phnom Penh. Initially, they were sent to Ren at the division headquarters, and he decided what was to be done with them. DK radio broadcast information from the confessions of Vietnamese prisoners of war who had been captured in Iso and sent to Phnom Penh during 1977-78. Is it correct, Mr. Witness, that the captured Vietnamese soldiers were captured by your
The division or the others conducted by Ren were to be sent first to the division headquarters. ប៉ុន្តែបើតាមច្បាប់តាមអ្វីកើតក្រមវាគឺខាងក្រមបច្ចាប់បានពីកងពលតូចយកពីអង្គភាពយកទៅបានមកទៅបញ្ជូនទៅនឹងហើយមកជូនទៅមេធំគឺរ៉ែនឹងហើយម្នាក់នឹងហើយប៉ុន្តែនេះក៏ខ្ញុំក៏ជំរាបចឹងមកជូនតាមពីធ្វើទៅតាមខ្សែរយៈតាមការចាត់តាំងគេលើពីកងពលតូចទៅកងពលធំយ៉ាងតាមនឹងហើយតាំងពីបញ្ជូនទៅណាទៀតនឹងក៏ក្លាប់ប្រហែលដែរពួកការងារទាំងអស់នោះវាហួស
ពីសមត្ថភាពខ្ញុំហួសពីទួលនីតិខ្ញុំខ្ញុំជម្រាបជូនលែងត្រូវហើយខ្ញុំជម្រាបជូនលែងត្រូវហើយអត់ទេបាទអរគុណឥឡូវនេះដល់ពេលសម្រាប់ថ្ងៃត្រង់ហើយអរគុណសម្រាប់ចាប់ពីនេះទៅទៅរហូតដល់ម៉ោង10ម៉ោង1នឹង30នាទីរសៀលនេះសូមអញ្ជើញជ្រុញបីបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្មការមន្ត្រីរដ្ឋបាលការនរមរួមរកកន្លែងសម្រាប់នៅបន្ទប់រងចាំមេមត្រាក់ស្័យ ដល់សាកសិរុនេះនៅក្នុងរងពេលសម្រាប់ថ្ងៃត្រង់នឹងអញ្ជើញគាត់រួមទាំងមេធាវីប្រឹក្សាសាកសិមកកាន់កន្លែងផ្ដោតធ្វើកម្មវិញនៅវេលាម៉ោង 1 និង 30 នាទីរសៀលហើយប្រកបឲ្យរយៈជាងគុំខាំងនាំខ្លួនលោកឈឺសំផនត្រឡប់ទៅកាន់ទីទៅកាន់កន្លែងបន្ទប់ស្នាក់នៅហើយនឹងឲ្យអញ្ជើញគាត់មកកាន់មកចូលរួមសម្មនាការនៅក្នុងបន្ទប់សម្មនាការនេះវិញរសៀលនេះឲ្យបានមុនម៉ោង 1 កន្លះសម្រាប់ចុះសូមអញ្ជើញក្រោកឈរ